The copyrighted program created by Rio Grande.
Buffalo Police hang all cars, and all cars don't get to any date. It was an accident. It may be an attempt murder. That's all. Close the question.
What kind of a tune does your self-starter play these brisk mornings? A short and sweet chord in G or a lengthy funeral dirge? If your motor doesn't take its cue at the first downbeat, don't blame the starter. Your gasoline is off key. Rio Grande cracked gasoline is the most harmonious blend of five vitally essential qualities purchasable in California, the most highly competitive market in the entire world. In the chilly morn and evening, or in the heat of midday sun, Rio Grande Cracks delivers quicker one-punch starting, steadier, velvet-smooth acceleration, greater speed, longer mileage, and a more abundant supply of reserve power. Who says so? The most exacting and best qualified judges of gasoline to be found anywhere. The men who drive the most as the pilots of your police cars, ambulances, fire engines, and other emergency equipment. Yes, the officials of 30 leading cities and counties throughout California specify Rio Grande Cracked as the gasoline to be used exclusively in powering all their emergency public serving cars. Many thousands of motorists have profited by the experience of these most eminent authorities, and so may you. There's a tank full of police car performance gasoline waiting for you at the nearest red and white station of your friendly Rio Grande dealer. Drive in tomorrow morning and call for it by either name, Rio Grande Cracked, or that police car performance gasoline. They mean the same.
It is our pleasure to present Inspector Anthony Collins.
Good evening, friends. Death never takes a holiday, and crime never ceases its unrelenting warfare with the police. Irrespective of motive, murder is still being considered a crime, and the police are daily tracking down men and women who thought they could kill and get away with it. Occasionally, a crime is so cleverly disguised that apparently the criminal does get away with his crime. But sooner or later, officers of the law will unravel the chain of clues that leads eventually to the capture and punishment of the offender. Tonight's story is stranger than fiction case. Obviously, we cannot use the name of the major motion picture studio in which it occurred, or the names of stars or directors, but that in no way to detract from the fascination of this intrigue and its solution.
One day, late in August, a group of chorus girls were rehearsing for a forthcoming picture on one of the sound stages of a motion picture lot.
Simplest routine on earth. You learn it in kindergarten, and you dames are mouthing it. Try it again.
From the beginning?
Yes, from the beginning. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, six. One. Stop it! Stop it!
Dancers, you're supposed to be. Why don't you go back to the house, hell's house, where you belong?
And you.
Who, me?
Yes, you. What are you imitating? A leaping fawn or a dying duck?
A dying duck? No, it's not a dying duck. And I don't know what a leaping fawn is.
Well, watch yourself do that hip stick in that mirror over there, and you soon will know. Now, look. This is the last time I'm going to show you.
Thank goodness for that.
And no wise cut. Now, watch. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, kick.
Oh, why didn't you say you wanted a hip kick?
Listen to her. Oh, there's another one that Nelson Dane picked out. All right, come on, let's do it. Maybe someday a cameraman will want to take a picture of this. I'm afraid. All right, let's go, Joe.
From the beginning?
Yes, the beginning. what did I ever do to deserve this? Some bunch ain't that dumb. Any one of those dames could start an asylum all by herself.
Well, why'd you pick them out?
Pick them out? Me? Pick them out? Don't make me laugh. Say, if I had my way, I'd throw the whole line out. And those lousy tunes with them.
Explain, Sammy.
You're one of those casualties with a pipe to pan. You gotta have tunes people can work them. Now, look at that gun. Listen, that's a song.
Now, you know something about tunes, Mr. Dutton.
You may have, but you didn't hear half enough. The person who wrote those songs ought to be shot.
Sammy,
I never in all my life.
Sammy, this is the lady who wrote the tunes.
Ah. You claim to be the lady who wrote these tunes.
Yes. You're the man who was producing the dances, aren't you?
What do you mean, was?
It's now a question of who's the most important around here. You or I. If I have any influence, you're out.
Listen, lady. I got a contract.
Frame it. Those numbers are going into this picture, and you're going out of it now. Suit yourself.
A minute, Sammy, take it easy.
You give me a contract to produce the musical numbers in this picture. Then you load me up with all the kitchen mechanics in Hollywood who think they can dance. And on top of that, this Flora Nelson dame writes the world's worst tunes, and I have to use them. Well, I won't do it.
Why, you...
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute, both of you. You break no contract, and we'll have no walkout. Flora, let me talk to Sammy alone for a minute, will you?
I'd like to talk to him alone. I'm staying here. Anything you've got to say to him, you can say with me here.
All right. All right, I'll say it to you then. Sammy, you're absolutely right. If you can find better girls for the line, hire them. As far as the music is concerned, we'll use a couple of Flora tunes, and we'll call him Dave Metzner to do the rest.
You mean we can get Dave out here from New York, and I can fire those mechanics?
Fire and hire anybody you choose. You are the boss.
How about this Flora dame?
She's my worry. Get busy.
Okay, boss.
Now let's go over to stage 8. We're paying an orchestra overtime now. They ought to be ready to rehearse that song from the new picture.
Okay, boss. But if I told you all I know about this game, you wouldn't argue with
I'm
me.
I'm not arguing with your family.
Listen, you little rat. Keep your trap shut about me or something's liable to happen to you.
Not to you, sister. I can take anything you can hand out.
Bill, we're ready to hear that song of Gin Stone.
Okay,
now
let's go.
Are
you ready for the time to fall in love? I'm all set. The stars are all aglow, and skies are blue above. Is it quick to know this night was made for love? The hour is growing late. So you really couldn't wait. It's time for you to fall in love with me. It isn't right to wait, with none in such a case. We should both make haste to find romantic bliss. The stars will fade away, so don't let your heart be made. It's time for you to fall in love with me. And the time of glory, golden moments steal away. Love will soon be going. Have a star, that's why you may. The season is complete, a perfect time and place. And heart, let me greet the dawn in your embrace. The stars and skies of blue seem to say they know it too. It's time for you to fall in love with me. The hour is growing late, so you really shouldn't wait. It's time for you to fall in love with me. The stars will fade away, so don't let your heart delay. It's time for you to fall in love with me. And the time of glory, golden moments steal away. Love will soon be going. where the stardust while you may. The setting is complete, a perfect time and place. Sweetheart, let me greet the dawn in your embrace. The stars and skies of blue seem to say they know it too. It's time for you to fall in love with me.
Well, what do you think of it, Timmy?
Well, Mary, now that's more like it. That's the kind of stuff we got to have to put the picture
that's
over.
That's the kind you will have.
Ah, it suits me, boss. Well, I'll see you later. I got to get back to the dance set.
So long, Timmy.
What's wrong out there? What's happened?
Oh, Mr. B, it's Sammy.
Timmy, what? Where is he?
There, under that big lamp. It fell on him from way up there. And now, Mr. B, he's dead.
What'd you see today?
Oh, nothing much. Bill Nye went over that action case out the studio.
Accident? What happened?
Some guy walked under a lamp. The lamp was on its way to the floor from the catwalk, and the guy isn't with us anymore.
Who was he?
Name's Fabian, I think. Yeah, Sammy Fabian.
Isn't it a little unusual for those lamps to fall?
Well, that's what I thought. I just had a talk with Captain Wallace. I reported his probable murder, incidentally.
Murder? What makes you think that?
Oh, just some things I overheard.
Anderson speaking.
Anderson. I want you and Tommy Devlin to follow through on that movie studio case. I'm not sure Devlin is so far wrong when he's not done that deal. Report to me in about an hour for further instructions.
Yes, sir. Well, that's that.
I believe. At the New York Metric.
Oh, come on in, darling. I'm hot at work.
Yes, I heard you.
Come on, Sally. I want you to hear it.
I knew it. Here it comes.
Oh, but you'll like this one.
It's beautiful day.
So are you. I wrote it for you, sir.
Seems you've written all your songs for me lately.
Why not? You are the sweetest girl in the world, you know. Oh, confound it. Somebody always knocks at the wrong time.
Telegram for Dave Metzner.
Excuse me, dear.
Mm-hmm.
Sally, listen. Want 4 tunes by August 15th for use Midnight Merriment. Name on price, please. Sally. Sally is what we've been waiting for. We're leaving tonight. We're going on that...
Please. But the telegram didn't say anything about me.
You don't think I'd move a ninja out of this town without you, do you? Oh, it'll be fun, Sally. It'll be fun. I'll write all the stuff I can on the train. We'll take my little studio piano, eh? We'll have to pack immediately. What's the matter?
I want a magazine.
Oh, you won't need it. You can listen to my song. Come on, we only have 4 minutes.
Well,
don't you dare miss that train.
I won't. I'll miss
it. Boy, here. Hi, Mr. Metzner.
What is it?
Telegram, sir.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
What is it, Dave?
Well, I don't know. I hope they haven't changed their minds. Sally, listen. Dave Metzner, Grand Central Station, New York. Have you ever noticed the similarity in rhythm between the clicking of a railway car wheels and the foxtrot NOLA? Unsigned. I wonder what the devil that means.
I'm back in the office of the head of the motion picture studio.
Come in, Joe. Sit down. This is Tommy Devlin from the Examiner and Lieutenant Sanderson from the police department.
Hi, boys.
They would like to ask you a few questions about that accident yesterday.
Anything I can do to help, I'd be glad to do. Tommy was a swell guy.
Well, just what happened, Joe, as you thought?
Well, I didn't exactly see it. You see, I was out in the alley talking to the girls after Sammy bawled him out.
Well, what did he bawl him out about, Joe?
Well, that was after he had his run-in with Flora Nelson, and He was just sort of excited and everything, you know.
Who's Flora Nelson?
That songwriter here in the studio.
Go on, Joe.
Well, after Sammy and Flora had their fight...
Oh, fight?
Yes, Sammy and Miss Nelson disagreed on some songs. Nothing serious.
Where was she when this accident happened?
I saw her going upstairs to her office while Sammy was in the studio talking to Mr. Pease.
Did anybody else see this lamp fall?
Well, me and Daisy were standing just outside the studio door when we heard Sammy yell. I think she saw it.
We'll talk to her later, Tommy. Let's take a look at that lamp again.
Well, there she is. What do you think, Sandy?
The question in mind is, did it fall or was it pushed?
Meaning which?
Doesn't make sense that a lamp as big as this one would become loosened by vibration in a studio that's built to eliminate vibration.
Now, that makes sense, too. So what?
So somebody had a reason for eliminating Sammy Fabian.
Well, assuming that, why and who?
Let's ask Daisy. And after Sammy said the tunes were stolen, what happened?
Well, then the Flora woman said, don't you accuse me of stealing tunes or I'll have you out of here if you have to be carried out.
What did Fabian say to that?
Well, he told her he had a contract.
Then what?
Then Flora said she'd have her tunes in the picture or he'd be out of the picture.
Well, thanks, Daisy. Just don't mention this to anybody, will you?
Oh, no, Lieutenant.
Well, where do we go from here?
Flora Nelson's office for a set of nice fingerprints to compare with those we found on the lamp.
Ridiculous. It's silly. Gotta get this done. I've got to work. How can I work if only those wheels would stop that infernal clicking? Can't let Sally know. Can't let anybody know. They think I'm crazy. Maybe I am. Oh, no. I'll try again. Now, let me see. I had an idea this morning while the train was standing still. Well, that's something like it. Now I've got it.
Listen to that. There it is again. Why can't I get that out of my mind? I've got to get it out. I'll be ruined if I don't. I've got to do something. Who is this?
It's Sally, Dave.
Oh, what do you want?
I want to see you, Dave. I must see you.
I'm busy, Sally. Can't you leave me alone?
If you won't be polite and ask me, and I'll come in anyway. Dave, something's wrong. I'm entitled to know what it is. Tell me, Dave.
Nothing's wrong. I'm busy. I'm trying to work. How can I work with you giving me pitying looks all the time?
Well, why should I be giving you pitying looks, Dave?
I don't know, but you have been. You've been talking to people about me, too. You think I'm crazy. Everybody thinks I'm crazy, but I'll show them.
Listen, dear. Come on out on the observation platform. We can talk it over.
Talk what over? What's there to talk over?
Lots, Dave. Before we left New York, you told me you loved me.
I do love you.
And you asked me to marry you. You remember?
Of course I remember.
When we boarded this train, we were as happy as two people could be. Then you came. You've become morose, irritable, so. We've been on the train 3 days, and you've accomplished nothing.
Say, are you criticizing me?
Oh, no, dear, I'm not criticizing you. But, Dave, this is your big chance. It's what you've been waiting for so long. You've got to have 4 songs ready when you step off the train. You've got to go into a picture. Dave, don't you realize...
You're afraid I won't make good, aren't you? Afraid I won't make enough money to buy you?
Dave, how can you say that?
We're not married yet. You can't come in here and dictate to me. No, oh, I'll write their songs. They'll be ready. I have an idea. It goes like this. You want to listen? You hear that? Their song. Now, don't you love it?
That's Nola, you're playing.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it? Great. Fits everything perfectly. Songs, rhythm. Oh, they'll get their rhythm. I'll give it all.
Oh, Dave, come to your senses, Dave.
Oh, you think I'm crazy, don't you? Songs, music, rhythm. I'll get rid of it. I'll show them. They can't ruin me.
Stop it, Dave. Don't tear up the numbers you've finished.
What, there are more than that. I'll tear his heart out if I ever get my hands on him. I'll kill him.
Oh, Dave, please be quiet.
Get out of here. For God's sake, get out of here. Get out.
Look, would you mind waiting just a minute, Mr. Henderson? I'm awfully busy right now.
Oh, sure, go ahead. We'll wait.
I've got the production with thousands of dollars spent already. I bring a man out here from the East to write songs, and all he brings me is a nervous breakdown and a fixation for singing Nola.
Nola? Why that question?
Mr. Pease, you say this man had a nervous breakdown on the train?
Yes, yes, he's in the hospital now.
Anybody you know of who might not want him to get that job?
Listen, Sanderson, you're making a melodrama out of this case. You've been snooping around here a week now, and all you've got is a few fingerprints and a theory. I'm telling you, Sammy Fabian's death was an accident. His breakdown of Metzner's is just a coincidence. It's bad, it's unfortunate, and to me it's costly, but it's still a coincidence.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Oh, good morning, Miss Nelson.
Good morning, Mr. Sanderson. How's business this fine rainy morning?
As usual, Miss Nelson, as usual.
Go into my office, Flora. I'll listen to the songs like this. Mm-hmm. Excuse me, won't you, Mr. Sanderson?
Oh, sure, sure. Don't mind us. We'll be around.
Say, wasn't Nola the name of that song we found in her office?
Yes, and that's the name of the song she scribbled on that scratch pad. Hey, Tommy, chase down to the Hollywood Telegraph office and check up on telegrams leaving here last week. I've got a hunch. I'll wait in the outer office. Well, Tommy, what'd you find out?
Plenty, copper. The records show that a woman answering this Nelson dame's general description sent a telegram to Dave Metzner about a week ago. Here's a copy of it.
Pardon me. Are you a police officer?
Why, yes. Why?
Well, I heard you mention Dave Metzner. You see, I'm Sally Dane. I know Dave Metzner very well. We came out here together. He was going to write some songs for Mr. Pease for his new picture. Listen, that's one of Dave's songs.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure he wrote it for me. I'd know it anywhere. I'm going to...
Now, wait a minute, Miss Dane. I'm Lieutenant Sanderson. This is Tommy Devlin, the news hawk. We'd like to talk to you a little more about this. Let's go down to headquarters. I have a feeling we're about to crack this case. Hey, wait a minute. Hold the phone. Tommy, give me that telegram you got from Miss Dane. And here, send a telephoto of this envelope we found in Miss Nelson's apartment to the New York police. Have them call me back. All right. Yes, here's the description of that telegram. L65-17, SERPDRN, Hollywood, California, 12:15 p.m. That's right. I want to see the clerk who took that message right away. Come in.
I'm the clerk who took that telegram you phoned about.
Oh. Here. Ever see that woman before?
Nice picture, isn't it? Yes, she's the woman who sent the wire.
That cinches it. Let's go.
Yeah, not so fast. Wait a minute. Lieutenant Sanderson speaking. Okay, put him on. Say, Tommy, take this down. New York calling. All right. Typewriter number B19476 38. Okay. Run it to Huntley Downs, July and August. Have you got him? Hold him. Tell him Flora Nelson confessed to stealing Metzner's manuscript. See what he says to that. Okay, thanks.
I sent for Miss Nelson. She'll be here in a moment. Come in. Oh, come in, Flora. You know Lieutenant Sanderson and Mr. Devlin?
I've seen them around.
They would like to ask you a few questions. I told them you wouldn't mind.
What kind of questions?
The kind the police usually ask, Miss Nelson.
Police?
Do you mind?
No, not at all.
I understand the late Mr. Fabian didn't think much of your music.
But I didn't think much of the late Mr. Fabian.
So I understand.
Just what do you mean by that?
I also gather that you didn't care for one Dave Metzner.
How does that concern you?
It doesn't, directly. You see, stealing copyrighted works is handled by the federal authorities.
It's a lie. Who says I stole Dave Metzner's song?
Huntley Downs, a gentleman now in custody of the New York police.
Flora, is this true?
I'll answer that for you, Mr. Pease. Downs has confessed that he stole the songs and sent them to Miss Nelson. In her apartment, we found burned copies of both songs.
How dare you go into my apartment?
We can also prove that she sent a telegram to Metzner in an attempt to ruin him.
Suppose I did send him that wire. I didn't think he was that near nuts. Well, if you gentlemen are through asking questions, I'll go.
So sorry. There's a little matter of a killing a man still to be settled.
You've got your nerve making such accusations against me. You can't prove a thing.
Miss Nelson, the police don't go about making statements they can't prove.
Now, we'd like to have your side of the story, but we must remind you about it being used against you. May I see you to our police car?
Any objection if I use Mr. Pease's washroom a moment? I'd like to powder my nose.
None at all. You won't need it, though. Not where you're going.
Maybe not.
Mind if I use your phone, Mr. Pease? Thanks. Listen, sister. Get me the examiner's city desk. Better keep your eye on that dame, Sandy.
No other door to that place. You won't run away.
Hello, Ed? Here's a lead on that studio case. Lieutenant Leroy Sanderson of the police department, following every possible clue, succeeded today in arresting Flora Nelson for the murder of... Wait a minute. Hello, Ed? Kill that story. Here's a new lead. Faced with arrest for the murder of Sammy Fabian, studio dance director, and possible charges of stealing copyrighted songs, Flora Nelson committed suicide this afternoon by shooting herself in the washroom. What? Oh, nuts. Make it her head, then.
Unbeaten and untied is a phrase that applies to very few football teams and to only one gasoline, Rio Grande Crack. It has the unbeatable triple threat combination of greater speed, power, and economy, and no other brand has been able to tie the quicker charging getaway and the smoother acceleration of Rio Grande Crack gasoline. When this finer motor fuel won the assignment of powering the emergency cars of 30 leading California cities and counties, it was pitted against the toughest sort of opposition. Last year, it gave a perfect performance in 55 million miles of law enforcement driving. No wonder many thousands of motors cheer the winning performance of the gasoline that goes through every season with an unbeaten and untied record. If you haven't experienced the thrill of such performance, join the growing army of loyal users of Rio Grande Cracked Gasoline not later than tomorrow morning. Get into the game yourself. Wheel in at the nearest red and white station of your Rio Grande dealer. Take on a tank full of Rio Grande Cracked Gasoline, and it will win police car performance for your car. And now, Inspector Collins.
Obviously, the names in tonight's story have, with the exception of the officers involved, been fictitious. There's an old saying, let sleeping dogs lie. I think that applies as well to crimes of this sort as any other thing. It is sufficient to point out that Flora Nelson's crime did not pay.
Thank you, Inspector Collins.
Police calling all cars, attention all cars. Cancellation broadcast 208 regarding a murder. Suspect in this case committed suicide in the presence of arresting officers. That's all. Golden Cliff.
Frederick Lindsley bidding you good night for Rio Grande.